That's why we call them black ships. So the huge size of the ship, right, all the people in Japan. And at last, the Japanese government gave in and decided to open two ports to the foreign countries, Shimoda and Hakodate. So Shimoda was the first place where the first American consul general fled. But this caused the fall of the Tokugawa period. So later on, I'm going to tell you why the Tokugawa period fell after 264 years.
And then here I can show you another interesting information, because during the Tokugawa period, the shogun lived in Tokyo, in Edo, and the emperor lived in Kyoto. So there were two positions coexisting for such a long time. But at that time, shogun knew he was the most powerful person, but he never killed the emperor in Kyoto. Because, you know, even at that time, for the most of the people in Japan, the emperor had been and was a spiritual leader. And then he still had some power to give some title to the samurai class. So the shogun thought it wiser to take the advantage of the emperor to control the people in Japan. So he sometimes visited the emperor in Kyoto, and he stayed in Nijo Castle. So Nijo Castle is in Kyoto, and it's just a temporary residence for the shogun when he visited the emperor in Kyoto. So the Nijo Castle is not exactly the castle. It's a residential style house. So it has a very decorative sliding doors, and everything inside was decorative. Yeah. And then it has some devices. Yeah. So one of them is a squeaking floor. So when you step on the floor, the floor squeaks. Because shogun was a dictator, so he was always afraid of being assassinated. That's why all these devices protected him from the attackers. So, have you been to Nijo Castle? Not yet? Maybe you have a chance to visit. You should visit, because it's a very decorative and very confusing device. Okay, now, here I can tell you another interesting information. So now, the present castle has only one moat around it. But the original castle used to have three moats around it. Inner, middle, and the outer. And the outer and the middle moats were filled in, so there are not today. But the outer moat once was a JR station. So from here, you will see the JR station. You will see the main street down there. And at the end of the street, you will see the building with the sign for Cesta. That's the JR station. That is where the outer moat used to be. It's so far away. And then within the inner moat, where the main tower stands, only the Lord and his family used to live. And between the inner and the middle moat, there lived a lot of samurai or warriors. And between the middle and the outer moat, there lived a lot of merchants, craftsmen, and lower class samurai. And outside the moat, there lived a lot of peasants. But 70% of the harvest went to the feudal lord. That's why all the peasants remained very poor all their lives. So this is the feudal system. And economy was based on rice. So the shogun was the top of the samurai, and under the shogun there were many feudal lords, and all of them were sent to the provinces. And their salary was calculated by how much rice the land produced. So the rice was the most important for the Tokugawa government.